Here are the best iPhone 16 hidden features, tips, and tricks. To this day, iPhone doesn't offer a basic restart button, but here's how you can create it on your iPhone using this simple trick. Open Shortcuts app, tap on the Add button, search Shut Down, and select it. Now tap on it and choose Restart. You can also choose the color and icon from here. When you're finished, tap on Done. Go to Sharing Options and select Add to Home Screen. And now you have a restart button on your iPhone. In case you don't want to make the extra effort of setting up a restart button, then you can simply ask Siri to do it for you. Hey Siri, restart the iPhone. The iPhone 16e supports Apple Intelligence, which is integrated with ChatGPT to provide enhanced user experience with advanced natural language understanding and generation. However, every time I want to use Apple Intelligence, it asks me for permission to use ChatGPT, which can be very annoying and not at all efficient. So, here's how you can bypass this. Just open Settings, go to Apple Intelligence and Siri, scroll down, and tap on ChatGPT. Now, turn off the Confirm ChatGPT Request toggle button, and done. Now, every time Siri has to use ChatGPT, it won't ask you for permission, which will increase the response time. Aside from Apple Intelligence, the iPhone 16e also supports something called Visual Intelligence, Apple's answer to Google's Gemini Live. It basically lets you share what you see from your phone's camera to the AI so that you can ask about it. I've actually done a detailed comparison of both these visual AIs, and you can check it out by tapping here. Back to the topic. On the regular 16 lineup, you can access Visual Intelligence by holding down the camera control. But since the 16e doesn't have a camera control, you have to open it through the Control Center. However, there's one other way. Go to Settings, Action button, and set Visual Intelligence. Now, you can easily access Visual Intelligence with just a tap of a button. iPhone 16e comes with a single 48-megapixel camera, which takes photos and videos that are on par with the iPhone 16 Pro. Don't believe me? Check out this video. But did you know that by default you can only take 12-megapixel photos on it? To take full advantage of this 48-megapixel sensor, open Camera Settings, tap on Formats, and turn on Resolution Control. Now, go back to the camera app, and here, you'll now see this HEIF Max option. Turn it on and shoot high-resolution 48-megapixel images with more details. But keep in mind that these 48-megapixel photos are almost 4 to 5 times larger in size. Next up, Back Tap. The Apple logo on the back of your iPhone isn't just for the show. It can also be used to control your iPhone. For example, I can do a double tap to take a screenshot and triple tap to open up a flashlight. There are a lot of other options which you can assign to these two gestures. To turn the Back Tap feature on, go to Settings, Accessibility, and Touch. Open Back Tap, then choose the action. Now, you can quickly access the functions you frequently use. The best part, it even works with a back cover. Just remember to tap gently for it to work every time. Back Tap is not the only way to control your iPhone 16e. There's also a feature called Vocal Shortcuts, through which you can control the functions of your phone just by speaking. For example, you can say Volume Up to increase the volume. You can say Torch to open the flashlight. Or you can just say Selfie to open the front camera. All these vocal commands are totally customizable, and you can choose across a variety range of system functions and accessibility features to assign. To turn it on, go to Accessibility Settings on your iPhone. Scroll down, select Vocal Shortcuts and set them up. Simply choose the action of your choice, enter the command name, say it 3 times, and done. Your vocal shortcuts are ready to roll. Now, let's tweak the Control Center of your iPhone 16e. You can make a widget out of any button on the Control Center. Simply press and hold to enter the Edit mode and expand any button into either a horizontal bar or a square widget. Also, I don't like how with iOS 18, the Bluetooth and mobile data buttons are now 2 taps away. To fix it, tap and hold the Control Center screen, select Add a Control, search for Bluetooth and cellular data to add it to your Control Center. Now, you can access them with just a single tap. You can even add your favorite apps to the Control Center for quick and easy access. I personally love listening to music, so I have added music streaming apps like Spotify and YouTube Music to my Control Center. To do that, simply tap on Add a button. Select Open App, choose the app of your choice, and just like this, it'll be added to the control center of your iPhone. Fiddling around all these customizations can sometimes even lead to a cluttered mess of buttons. But don't worry, just open Settings on your iPhone, go to the control center, and tap on Reset Control Center. It'll revert back to the original layout. Here's another customization trick for you outside the control center. Go to the app screen and press and hold on any app icon. On most apps, you'll find these widget icons. Select them and your app icons will turn into widgets. Look how neat and aesthetic it looks. Besides this, you can also tap on this edit icon. Select Customise and then freely edit how your app icons will look. You can increase their size and freely customize the color to create the most personalized app screen on your iPhone. All these changes will even show in the settings page. Let me show you how to add your name on the lock screen of your iPhone 16. Open Control Center and long press on Focus. Tap on New Focus and select Custom. Now, type in your name, select a color, choose an icon, and done. Now turn on the mode with your name and it will be displayed on your lock screen. Whenever you're texting someone in iMessage, you can add some really cool effects to your text. Just select the particular text and tap on this A icon. It'll show a drop-down of many animation effects which you can add to your texts. You can add multiple effects in a single message or add a single effect to highlight something in your message. It's a really cool hidden feature on your iPhone. The next tip is about an app called Invites, which you can get from the App Store. This app requires iCloud Plus subscription, but it lets you create amazing invites that not only looks cool, but also facilitates efficient event management. You can use one of the preset backgrounds or use your own photo as one. You can edit the title from here, choose the date, time, and place. You can even add an event description. Share albums or playlists with other participants. The best thing about it is that you can send this invite link to both iOS and Android users. Thanks to this app, you can ascertain how many people you'll be expecting to arrive for the event. Here's another cool feature to try on your iPhone 16, Genmoji. Basically, now your emojis are powered by AI. You can create some really interesting new emojis, like this German Shepherd surfing emoji. And the best part is that you can even use it in third-party apps like Instagram. Last but not the least, Image Playground. This is an AI-powered image generator that lets you create some really unique images. You can select a person's photo to create a character and add different elements to it. Or you can get really creative and generate an image from scratch. It is really fun. So, those are the best hidden tips and tricks that can make your experience with the iPhone 16 a lot more interesting. Comment below if you already tried any of these or if I missed any. Give it a like if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.